for Rayburn. And my background for choreography is pretty extensive. Been choreographing for about 26 years. My master's degree is in human performance, which is just that study of how the body relates to performance and how you use it, you know, aesthetically and things like that. So I'm going to show you some clips, dance as poetry, and relate it back to the meaning behind it. So our predecessor did. And this is Tori, Bales.
So first I'm going to show my solo from this year that I did at competition season. It's to I Surrender by Celine Dion. And for me, it was more about taking everything I have learned in dance since I was little and putting it on the floor for the last time. So we'll watch that one right here. It's
alright.
Using the music and using the lyrics. So that's poetry motion right there. So
okay, so I'm a great public speaker, I brought my notes. But first I want to say, to me the definition of poetry is a mixture of words to create a rhythm or a pattern expressing an emotion or telling a story. And to me dance is the same way. We mix slow moves and fast moves together to get different styles, different rhythms, different beats, to express how we feel and to create a story. So, poems and dance are very similar, both in forms of expression. In a poem, the words and diction create a mood and express the author's emotion. In dance, we use movement to express how we feel or to tell a story. I always tell the girls that there's a difference between dancing and performing. In a performance, you use all of the technique that we've all learned and also your emotion to create a story. If you get into what you are doing, the audience will understand the story, believe you, and feel the same way that you do about the topic or subject. The same is for a poem. The authors want to capture their audience. Both also take the same mindsets. A lot of people don't appreciate dance, which is very frustrating. But just like an author, we have to have a very creative mind, broad ideas, and be exposed to many different topics so that we can use that in dance to create a story. Authors expressing themes or themselves throughout a poem, they express and talk about death and love, happy and sad topics, and dance is the same way. We tell people how we feel without talking, and I feel like that's the best definition of why dance is a poem about birth.
And it depends on who your audience is, just like in art. Sometimes the artist just paints something for themselves, and they're that's their audience. The dance that we do is for judges, it is for an audience, so it is a performance technique. And there are two different styles of dance. Studio dance is not always for performance, so you can have a little more liberty with that. This next dance is my choreography, and I created the motif, and I want to explain that. In music, when you're connecting things together, you would call that a hook, as the kids call it. You know, there are musical terms I won't bore you with. In poetry, it's it depends on what the pentameter is of it. And when you're creating a dissertation or something, you would have a thesis statement that would be the underlying theme through the entire thing. So before I start my choreography, I listen to the music about 1,000 times, and then I create the construct of it is what we call a chart. Just like in music, it has a certain beat or rhythm to it, and that's what I first diagnose. And then I break it up into sections, depending on where I want the movement to go. Because it is for an audience, it's not just for me, or it would be completely different. It is for other people to see, and the audience wants to have an emotional connection. Or dance, when you have a repeat, you call it a motif, and that's what you're trying to create. And you don't have to do the same exact movement, but in this piece we actually did, so I'm gonna show you the beginning and the end of it. I think you'll get that.